features painting, desks, chairs, sculpture, lamp, conference table, globe, plants and bench. Functioning elevator with space for two minifigures and ladder access to roof. Bell tower features bench and maintenance ladder. Roof features skylight with view inside the building. Address the citizens from the balcony. This classic three-story town hall building is the latest addition to the LEGO Modular Buildings series. This highly detailed model features large entranceway columns and coat of arms, a tall bell tower with clock and a large skylight giving a view inside the building. On the ground floor, the large hall, tax office and auditorium are perfect for servicing the town's citizens. Take the working elevator up to the secretary and mayor's offices on the second floor, furnished eloquently with desks, chairs, paintings and even a frog sculpture. There's even a balcony for addressing the town's citizens. On the third floor, a spacious meeting room features a large conference table, chairs, globe and plants. Includes 8 minifigures, mayor, secretary, bride and groom, press woman, janitor and 2 children. Review: every town needs a town hall, right? And this town hall does stand out impressively, even alongside all the other modular buildings in LEGO's wonderful series. It seems like an essential addition to any LEGO town. It is one of the few that is truly modular in that you can display it with just the ground floor and roof, or the ground floor, first floor and roof, or the ground floor, second floor and roof, or all three floors, with the first above the second or the second above the first. Mix and match. 5 viable configurations, change the display every day. And when you play with its modularity like this, magic happens. As built, the structure is imposing but a bit bland. But when you take away the first floor and have just ground floor, second floor and roof, voila! You get an amazing schoolhouse. It has a much better sense of proportion than the full set, and also the wonderful detailing of the entrance facade dominates, whereas with the full set it tends to be a bit buried visually as the eye is drawn upward. And what would you do with that middle section? Well, it is a perfect shape for a nice single-story house. Just change the front door, remove the balcony and add a roof. The elevator area becomes the bathroom. Yes, the set has a working elevator rather than stairs. So we have nice lounge, bedroom and toilet, with plenty of space in the atrium area for kitchen and dining, and for extending the bathroom. And that's what LEGO Friends sets are for. I have plenty of them for refurbishing my modulars. As for the set itself, this is the second last in the original series, which ends with the Palace Theater. After that, the modulars have focused more on internals and play features, to the point where somewhat childishly gimmicky toy features dominate the building design of the brick bank and detective's office, to the detriment of the actual building itself. The earlier modulars are more solidly aimed at adult fans of LEGO, and at creating imposing buildings and especially facades for a LEGO town. The town hall holds together well and is easy to transport and clean. It is probably my second favorite of the 11 modulars published so far.